saw was a more general overview of manual spec. This video that we're going to do today is going to be a more detailed version of that, specifically covering the application portion. Now, for this video, I have four different colors. I have my base coat and my three flat colors. It's going to be a gray tone. The first part of manual spec is going to be applying your base coat. My base coat, I'm going to apply it using just the part A and the part B. I'm not going to use any of the thinner. The reason for that is that I want the flat colors that I throw on top that are mixed with the thinner to melt into the base coat. Good enough. When applying the base coat, what you want to do is first apply a really thin coat with your air pressure turned all the way up. That's the off position. This is 100% open. Anytime you spray a countertop, you always want to get your hardest areas first, whether it be your backsplash or your edges. Always do them first, and then you can go over the top of the flat parts. In the commercial setting, specifically apartments, the reason I do this first is, especially in an apartment setting, you're probably going to be applying this over a countertop that's already been resurfaced before. Doing it this method, you can see if you're going to get a reaction anywhere and to make sure that it's going to adhere properly. Once this begins to tack, you can apply your second flood coat. For that, I'm going to open up the valve. For my second coat, I'm going to open up the valve to ensure that more coating comes through the gun and out the needle. Now that I've applied the second coat, I can proceed with creating the manual specs. For this portion, you can do many different patterns, but always have it at a 45 degree. That way you can create that circle pattern. The size of the tip that I have on here is a 1.4. It doesn't necessarily have to be a big one. Even with this tip, you can create really small dots or really big dots. Okay, for this first counter right here, I'm gonna do a pattern with really small dots. And then on the next ones, I'm gonna proceed to do bigger and bigger ones. Another tip, if you're using a regular cup gun, the issue with this is that you only use about 10% air pressure. So that's not enough pressure to push the coating through the tube and out the front of the gun. So with this technique, you might have to tilt it a little bit to ensure that the coating goes through the tube and out the front. Okay, for this counter, we're gonna do more medium-sized flood. For that, after we do the base coat, I'm gonna pull the needle back to about 50% to where the needle pulls back about halfway. The air pressure is still gonna be about the same level. What this does is the coating shoots out more at a larger volume, therefore creating the larger fleck. Thank you. For this last counter, we're going to try to get the fleck as big as possible using the 1.4 needle. For this, we're going to open the valve as much as we can to allow the needle to open as much as possible. The trigger's most likely going to be going all the way to the back for this. Because there's so much coating going through the tube, the air pressure might have to be slightly higher than you would do with a smaller fleck. Thank you. Okay, so there's, as you can tell, there's many ways to shoot this manual spec. But as far as the technique portion of it is, you're gonna have it in a circle pattern when you're shooting, right? So for me, and especially with bottom fed guns, since you have to tilt it, I like to just squeeze it, pull it back to whatever setting you have it as far as possible, squeeze it, and then just do a circle pattern until you fill it all in. Like I said in the beginning, always do your most difficult areas first. Like I said in the beginning, always do your most difficult areas first. So that's going to be your sides, your corners, and any back splashes that you have. And the reason for that is that if you do the top areas first and they look good, when you go to get the side, you're going to get it onto the top, and then those areas are going to be a lot heavier than the rest of the countertop, and it's going to ruin the pattern. Another suggestion is any counter that has a bar top on top, do the bar top first. Also, if you see any areas that are bald, or you might have missed a little bit of the pattern, don't aim your gun directly at where you want it to be. Aim it off of that. The reason for that is that you're shooting the circle pattern, your coating is going to land on the outside circle of exactly where you're aiming. Everything you should have your mouth. Yeah. I'm trying to figure out what to say at the end though, like an outro.